Hey everybody, it's Julin and Catherine. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to our Canoga Park, California Plant Friend Plant Haul. That is a really long title, but that's exactly what we're going to be doing today. So 2 days ago, we set out to Canoga Park to another location that we've never been to before. And I was really excited to take Catherine to this place. It's definitely like a hidden mom and pop gem. Which, by the way, guys, if you haven't watched that Come With Me, go ahead and check out my last Come With Me on the channel. You can see where we adventured, and that place was really cool. There are so many cool plants there, and not only that, but the owners are really nice, and they were very dog friendly. So give this video a big thumbs up for another Plant Friend Plant Haul. Catherine got a whole bunch of plants. I did get a repeat plant and a replacement plant. One of my plants died from the rain. And I purchased it for the fourth time. After this, there's no more. I went on a Hoya theme. Catherine got a bunch of different cool plants. So give this video a big thumbs up for once again having Catherine back on the channel and for another plant haul for the month of April. So sound off down below, guys. Also, I'm interested, when was the last time you purchased the plant? That'd be something good to know, because every time it's like, oh, I just bought one yesterday or today. But the last time we bought a plant was 2 days ago. Let's go ahead and talk about one of the plants that you got. I got two plants. She got a handful, a box full actually of plants. So let's go ahead and talk about Catherine's first plant find. And I want to know why you got this and if you have this plant in your collection, or just tell me maybe the history of why you like this particular plant. Because for me, guys, I am getting no more of these plants. I've had enough. I got a bunch of them. They all died and that's it for me.
Okay. So confession, I have killed one of these plants. Okay. In California, but I used to have tons of success with these in Florida, so I'm in love with them. And it is this gorgeous caladium, and they come in so many different varieties. What I really was attracted to is the curly leaves. Can you see how it's so ripply, curly?
Love that.
Love those curly leaves. So I'm not sure what I did, Julin, to the first one. The first one that I killed was living in my bathroom.
Okay.
And I have a feeling that because I do have a window that has that kind of privacy screen.
Okay.
So it has some kind of filter to it, but it's still very hot. And I think I had it in a window that was too much direct sunlight. So okay. I'm gonna take another approach with this one. Maybe keep it in a hanging basket. Away from the direct sunlight. I'm probably gonna go bathroom.
Okay.
I have to say, initially at least, because
I would do the same.
I'm a little worried. A little worried about just needing less heat and less sunlight.
Okay.
Okay. So as if one caladium wasn't enough, I got two caladiums.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna live through her with the caladiums, because I swear I think I had five and they all died.
So just also this one attracted to me, just the lime color and the little spots, little pink spots, just so attractive. Such an attractive plant.
It is.
Really loved it.
Caladium, here they are, side
caladium
by side.
Caladium number two. Little buddies.
All right, so I'm gonna talk about my one replacement plant here. So here you go, guys. I got another Hoya carryi. This is the fourth one I got. My original ones were like three times bigger than this, which is unfortunate. But they all died from the rain while I was away from Egypt. That happens. A whole bunch of sansevierias died. A lot of plants struggle because I wasn't here. That's what happens when you do travel. Things like that happen, especially when you live in an environment where your plants are outside. You can't control the weather when you're away. So this is my one replacement plant. This is the fourth time I'm purchasing this plant. So therefore, if this does not survive in my collection, I will be getting no more horacariis. So I got this plant, and it's a pretty good size. So stay tuned. I'm going to go ahead and add this back in the Hoya collection. Guys, like after three times, that is it. Like my maidenhair, my caladiums, I'm not getting any more. Alocasia African mass, not getting any more. But the Hoya carryi, because I'm a huge Hoya collector, this is the fourth time and it wasn't my fault. It was the rain's fault. So I'm going to give myself another chance to go ahead and raise another Hoya carryi in my collection. Kat, speaking of Hoyas, I think we should talk about your one Hoya that you got.
Also a repeat for me, but...
I was gonna get one too, but I already have three of these.
Maybe I'll see some flowers sometime soon.
Yes, keep it in your patio.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so on the Hoya trend, I'm gonna talk about my last plant that I got. So I got a repeat plant. This is a Hoya Bella. Now, you know, last time Catherine and I did a big Come With Me to Northridge, California. That was the first time I've ever seen the Hoya Bella in person. I picked it up, but guys, this one is like 2.5 times bigger than my original Hoya Bella, which I got probably maybe 3.5-4 weeks ago. And I'll do that.
Takes up the whole frame.
You know, I will do that. If I see a plant that's bigger than my original plant or just one leaf is different, I'll go ahead and do a repeat purchase. So I don't know what I'm going to do with my original Hoya Bella. I may go ahead and sell off some cuttings, or I'll just keep both of them. I'm not too sure. If you guys are interested in the Hoya Bella, I have so much. I don't mind selling cuttings from it. You guys know that if I have a certain plant that you guys want, I can go ahead and sell it off to you. Parts of it if it doesn't ruin the plant. So reach out to me, Planting with Julen, on Instagram if you guys are interested. But this, guys, I'm definitely interested to see it in a white planter, thriving and living in my collection. Again, like, look at how full this is.
No yellow, no spots.
I know.
Nothing wrong with it.
My original Hoya Bella, there was some spots on there. And it's kind of like on a faded green versus, like, this is a little bit more vibrant and dark and absolutely, like, no spots. And I know I did mention in my plant haul for that particular video with my original Hoya Bella, like, I was kind of concerned, like, what's the spots doing on the plant, like, why is it kind of on a lighter green side? But look at the chlorophyll, it's so green on here. So I had to repurchase a plant, so I'm glad. I love it so much. You guys know, like, I have Hoya Carnosa tricolor, like, four of them all living in my collection. I will do that. So Hoya Bella, because it's a rare plant, I've never really seen it often. This is the second time I've ever seen it. I did a repurchase. So with that being said, that is all the two plants that I got on the Hoya train. And Kat, I'm really excited for the two last plants that you got, which I also have in my collection. So let's go ahead and talk about it.
Okay, two last plants, String of Hearts.
You guys already know I have two of them. One from West Hollywood, one recently from Las Vegas, and a variegated one that I got from Santa Barbara. And Catherine, have you seen a String of Hearts in person this big before for yourself?
I almost feel like it looks like a bird's nest. Like, it looks wound up around itself.
Yes, I can't wait to see it.
If I untangle that, it's going to trail. I feel like it's compact in the container that it's in right now. When I replant that, I feel like we're going to get a lot more trickling out of the pot there.
And you guys, the String of Hearts is super easy to propagate. But stay tuned for Catherine's Spring 2019 plant tour. You'll go ahead and see all of these new babies styled in her home. Now, if I didn't have two String of Hearts, Julen probably would have gotten another String of Hearts, just because, like, I couldn't. This is so stunning. I can't believe it. But I held back and I just stuck with the Hoyas. But if for some apparent reason I didn't have two, I would have purchased my second one there, because I think it was an absolute steal. And it was definitely, like, one of the highlights, and I think in that come with me, was seeing the String of Hearts, and there was so much to choose from too.
Yeah, it was on my list for sure, and you gave me some dolphin cuttings that was on my list.
Yeah.
Yeah. So adding this to pearls and ruby necklace and dolphins, and so just kind of getting my string of collections on.
Yeah, I love curly plants.
And then I think my favorite thing, because I've wanted one for a long time, but I really just, because they tend to be, gosh, at least close to us, expensive. The monasteras are expensive.
Monasteras are very expensive.
Yeah, so a really just lovely monastera. It's a good size. It's not huge. I don't have a lot of space, so it's not enormous yet.
Love it, Kat.
And it was very reasonable. And, like, honestly, I've probably been waiting almost a year to get one of these, just because I didn't want to spend the kind of money that
and
they
guys,
charge
I
around
told
here.
Her, look, if you don't get it, you can get one from me. I have lots of babies. But she was like,
I said, no way.
Too long to wait.
Yeah, so that guy's pretty gorgeous. And I especially like the leaves that look all Swiss cheesy, you know. Yeah, love it.
Before we go ahead and wrap up the video, I have a big box.
So big.
Shout out to Kira all the way in Las Vegas, my bestie. She will be back on the channel soon, guys. But I go out to Las Vegas once a month now. She sent me home with a bunch of these cuttings. And if you watch my Las Vegas plant haul, Planting with Julen, you've seen her mom's big prickly pear tree. And well, it got cut down, half of it. And she went ahead and propagated all of the tails. And she has pricks all over her. But she gave me a box full to bring back. So I said, you know what? I'm gonna spread some plant love. I'm gonna give all my friends. I'm gonna save some for you guys too. So stay tuned for an upcoming little giveaway. But Kat, I want you to have the first picking.
Let's
so go.
Go
ahead and dig in.
Let's go. And the tongs, right? The tongs. Okay, I'm getting this guy. I'm gonna get a few.
Yeah, pick
just
out a few.
Just because I know you have so many.
Yeah, there is. And then let me see how you style them.
I don't want too big though, because Julen has a lot more room than I do. I'm gonna get that one.
And
what do you think? Should I get a little one?
It's up to you. There's all kinds.
Okay, I'm gonna get a little one too. A little one.
Aw, that is cute.
Yep. Yep.
Do you want one more?
Sure.
Okay. I'm going to see Tanya, I'm going to see Carrie, and they're also going to be able to pick out some cuttings
that one,
too.
That one. Also, not too huge.
Oh, actually, that's a good one.
Yeah, that is a good one.
Yay! Happy planting, okay. Catherine. That is going to wrap up our Canoga Park plant friend plant haul of all of the plants that we got 2 days ago in our last Come With Me. Sound off down below what was your favorite plant in today's plant haul, and also give this video a big thumbs up. If this video gets 500 likes, I will go ahead and take myself and my channel over to Catherine's house and film her spring 2019 plant tour. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Catherine, out of all of the plants, what was your favorite?
The Monstera for sure.
Okay. Yeah. And I can't choose between the two Hoyas. I love them both so much. So if you guys enjoy seeing our collective plant friend plant haul and having Catherine back on the channel, give this video a big thumbs up. I know you guys love seeing Catherine back on the channel as much as I love having her over. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you guys are new, welcome to the channel. Hit the bell and subscribe button to be notified on my daily uploads. I have well over 400 videos, soon to be over 500
videos. You could
videos.
Watch something every day.
I know. I know. I get inspired. So if you guys are new, subscribe, hit the bell to be notified, and I will see you guys tomorrow. You can find more on my blog at ellajulin.blogspot.com. Until next time, aloha from Catherine and I at my home here in Santa Monica, California. Bye, guys.